Hello, everyone. Welcome to our latest video. Today, we're diving into one of the most innovative and fastest aircraft of World War II, the Dornier Du-335, also known as the Pfeil Aero. This plane wasn't just fast. Du-335 holds the title as the fastest propeller-driven aircraft of its time, with a revolutionary design that pushed the boundaries of aviation technology. In this video, we'll explore how German engineers managed to create this groundbreaking aircraft with its unique push-pull engine configuration, combining power and aerodynamics in a way rarely seen before. We'll also discuss the Du-335's performance, the challenges it faced during production, and why this extraordinary plane arrived too late to make a significant impact on the war. The Dornier Du-335, also known as the Pfeil Aero, holds a unique place in aviation history as the fastest piston-engine aircraft of World War II. This groundbreaking design by German engineers combined innovative technology with unmatched speed, making it a standout in the waning days of the war. With its unconventional push-pull engine configuration, featuring one engine at the nose driving a tractor propeller and another at the rear powering a pusher propeller, the Du-335 broke through the limitations of traditional propeller-driven planes. In the waning years of World War II, amidst the chaos and desperation of a crumbling Third Reich, German engineers unveiled an extraordinary aircraft that challenged traditional design conventions. The Dornier Du-335, often referred to by its nickname Aero, represented a bold leap in aviation technology. With its unique push-pull engine configuration, featuring propellers at both the nose and the tail, this innovative fighter sought to achieve unprecedented speed and performance. It was a testament to German engineering prowess, a machine that promised to redefine the capabilities of piston-engine aircraft. However, its story is one of brilliance overshadowed by the harsh realities of war. The origins of the Du-335 date back to the 1930s, when aviation pioneers began experimenting with unconventional aircraft designs to overcome the limitations of existing technology. German engineer Claudius Dornier spearheaded this effort, leveraging his company's reputation for pushing the boundaries of aeronautics. Dornier envisioned a high-performance aircraft powered by twin engines that combined the streamlined efficiency of a single-engine airframe with the power of dual engines, a concept that became the foundation for the Du-335. Dornier championed the push-pull engine design, which used a front engine to drive a propeller pulling the aircraft forward and a rear engine to push with an additional propeller. Unlike wing-mounted engines, this setup reduced drag and eliminated the asymmetrical thrust issues common in conventional twin-engine designs. The result was a streamlined aircraft offering greater stability and higher speed potential. In theory, the push-pull configuration delivered the best of both worlds. The clean aerodynamics of a single-engine fighter paired with the raw power of twin engines. However, bringing this concept to life posed numerous technical challenges. Engineers had to address complex issues, such as synchronizing the propellers and ensuring effective cooling for the rear engine. These hurdles required creative solutions to make the design viable. The final Du-335 design emerged as a blend of necessity and innovation, boasting dual engines for unmatched power and a simplified airframe optimized for speed. The rear engine provided additional thrust, while the front engine drove the main propeller, creating one of the most advanced piston-engine aircraft ever conceived. The Luftwaffe recognized the Du-335's potential as a versatile platform in 1942, seeking faster and more adaptable fighters to counter the Allies' growing dominance. Designed for roles such as interception, ground attack, and reconnaissance, the Du-335 promised superior speed, range, and firepower. But before it could enter combat, rigorous testing was necessary to ensure mechanical reliability and aerodynamic efficiency. Wind tunnel experiments confirmed its sleek profile, and prototypes allowed engineers to refine its intricate push-pull engine system. These efforts paved the way for a high-performance aircraft tailored for combat. The Du-335's cockpit was another marvel, prioritizing pilot comfort and situational awareness. With excellent visibility and advanced instrumentation, it allowed pilots to harness the aircraft's full potential. It became clear that the Aero was not merely an experimental aircraft. It represented a bold leap into the future of aviation. Development of the Du-335 progressed rapidly, with its first flight on October 26, 1943. Test pilots were impressed by its speed, maneuverability, and climb rate, which set it apart from other piston-engine fighters of the era. Capable of reaching speeds of up to 474 miles per hour, the Du-335 was the fastest piston-engine fighter of its time. Pilots noted its responsive controls and impressive acceleration, and its innovative design maintained stability even with one engine disabled. These promising results led to plans for mass production and broader operational roles. Armed with two 20mm cannons mounted in the wings and a 30mm cannon firing through the propeller hub, the Du-335 was well equipped for both air and ground targets. Its versatility was further enhanced by the ability to carry bombs or auxiliary fuel tanks on underwing hardpoints. This allowed the aircraft to engage enemy bombers with devastating firepower, while also excelling in ground attack missions. Its speed and climb rate made it an ideal platform for hit-and-run tactics, providing a significant tactical advantage in combat scenarios. The Dornier Du-335, also known as the Aero, is fascinating due to its remarkably well-thought-out design, which, despite the great weight of the aircraft, conveys a delicate and almost dainty appearance. This apparent likeness was no coincidence, but the result of an innovative and sophisticated technical implementation. A decisive factor for this design was the placement of the main landing gear. The main landing gear legs were located almost centrally between the two engines and directly under the main tank. This not only ensured a stable distribution of the center of gravity, but also enabled an unexpectedly light and slim design of the landing gear. Despite the well-thought-out design, the technology of the Du-335 was not free of problems. The nose landing gear, in particular, repeatedly caused difficulties in practice. There were frequent malfunctions when extending, which led to additional maintenance costs. Another interesting special feature of the Du-335 was the boarding ladder, which was necessary because the wing roots were attached at a height of around 2 meters. The diameter of the main wing tires alone was more than a meter, which underlined the sheer size of this aircraft. To reach the cockpit, the pilot needed a special ladder that was elegantly stowed in the left wing root. This two-part, foldable ladder enabled the pilot to reach the trailing edge of the wing and from there reach his workplace in the cockpit. Another technical highlight of the Du-335 was the control of the rudders, which posed a particular challenge. Due to the enormous top speed of the aircraft, the ailerons, rudder, and elevator had to be controlled in a precise and at the same time robust manner. While the rudders were conventionally operated via rods, the special feature was a two-stage transmission. With the help of an electro-hydraulic control, the transmission could be adjusted manually via a toggle switch in the cockpit. The first stage was designed for low speeds between 200 and 400 km/h, while the second stage was designed for speeds over 400 km/h. This function gave the Du-335 exceptional versatility and precision in control. After the A0 pre-series, the first models for series production were developed. A distinction was made between the A and B variants, which introduced some airframe-specific improvements. There were a large number of planned sub-variants that were intended to make the Du-335 an extremely flexible multi-purpose aircraft. These included variants as destroyers, fighter bombers, trainers, night fighters, and reconnaissance aircraft. The two-seater variants, such as the night fighter and the trainer, were particularly interesting, as the additional crew member was seated behind or above the pilot in a separate cockpit.